Welcome back into the Madison Marriott West Hotel in MidwestLAN 20. This Rocket League Open is a 2v2, and it is for the lion's share of $1,000. The nice part is we have three teams remaining. All of them at this point are in the money. I am Curtis. I'm along with Dazzer and Daz, two teams that have shown some very, very good skill vie for a chance to go to the grand finals.
Yeah, and the competition doesn't stop here as both these teams are in the loser's final trying to get into the grand final. They play a best of three here, and the winner of that goes on to play a best of seven in the grand finals, but obviously, the team that is in the winner's final will have a one game advantage.
Yep, as we saw just a minute ago, Game of Throws, they got past Mech OG. They now have a best of three separating them and the grand finals. Also standing in their way is Mom Buy Me Legos, and those guys, one of them is the defending champion of this tournament. The other one was a second place participant in the last tournament. This should be a good game either way. Both teams show strong competition.
Exactly. There's a lot of competition here, and I'm excited to get this one going,
yeah.
Curtis, because I think the players speak for themselves when they get on the pitch. So we are ready when they are. But
yep.
Honestly, you want to see – oh, wow, we got them in right now, actually.
Excellent.
So we're about to get it going. Let's go.
Yeah, we are. We are indeed. Shout out to the family that's here for Parker and Andy as well. I see you over there in the crowd been cheering on those boys all day long. We are underway and ready to go in a best of three. DFH Day, the sight and the first goals on the board already. Andy has the first strike 6 seconds in.
And that's one way to start it off. Andy coming up big, and then you see him go under this ball. Oh, he actually gets the flip reset and flicks into it. I love it. It's a great opening start for Game of Throws.
6 seconds in already. Game of Throws up one. Mom Buy Me Legos looking to retaliate fairly quickly. Legos going to go after the kickoff, and he will get the advantage for the moment. But well read by Game of Throws. Good takeaway by Mom. Mom is gonna try to get there first, but a nice read by Andy. Gonna get this deep into orange territory. Mom, rotating in, taking a shot. That's near side off the post, and no help there from Lego, who had rotated back all the way for boost. And now it looks like Game of Throws can have a little bit of offense.
Yeah, the Game of Throws team, you can tell that they're going with some high-octane offense. There's Parker, he's got a big shot, and he's gonna hit it in. Game of Throws go up by two in the first minute.
Aerial pass on the point. Good read from Andy, realizing he can put this up into the center. Parker knows exactly what Andy's gonna do. These two have played together, they show that chemistry.
Yeah, exactly. And man, they're starting to get warmed up. Mom Buy Me Legos coming into this match. They need to get into it because this is not a good start for them. A two-goal cushion for Game of Throws, and they're in full control of this game.
2-0 again, only 40 seconds in, so tons of Rocket League left, especially in a three-game set. That's a 2v1 odd man rush for Mom Buy Me Legos, but it does not equal into instant offense for the moment. Big demo as Parker goes down. He'll have to wait 3 seconds to play again. Here comes Andy. Andy gets a nose on it, looking for the carry. It's going to go off the lateral wall. Chance off the bottom.
Is that in?
Oh, very close. Mom comes up with a key save to keep that one away. 3:55 to go, but good offense coming out from Game of Throws.
They're starting to get comfortable, Curtis, and you can see it on the field. That was a slick shot from Andy, almost able to get that one and extend the lead to three. Mom Buy Me Legos, they have to turn up the heat. They got to get in their faces because they're giving them too much space at this point, and they're having fun on the ball.
This is going to be Mom in the corner. Top of the box, looking to keep it in play for Lego, but Lego has to turn back and catch it. Good clear by Game of Throws. That could be a problem for Legos. Mom comes out from the goal line to take it away. This will ricochet towards the sidewall again. Game of Throws has the offense. Taken away by Lego. Lego into the corner. Looking to try to get this into the mid. It flies well over the head of Mom. That's a runner back the other way, and that's going to find its way home. Andy finds the empty net, making a 3-0 lead.
It's a great goal here for Andy. He's really quick to the ball on this, and he gets the catch. Mom Buy Me Legos, they went all in on the offense there. Definitely overcommitted on the pitch, and it didn't work out into their favor. All it took was one pinch, and they were out of position. And now they got to come back from a three-goal deficit.
187 seconds to go in game number one, but who's counting? This will be over the halfway line. Taken in by Parker. Parker looks, tries to carry, gives it over to Andy. Game of Throws trying to keep it in, but it's taken well away by Mom. Up is Lego, trying to angle this, gets it off the wheel well, and it's sent along by Game of Throws as they take it back on offense. Andy loses possession in midfield. That's potentially a problem. Mom comes in, but a nice play by Parker to get in front of him and the net. This will be off the back, still a chance for Legos, and Mom can't quite turn in. now might have an offensive opportunity. Angled shot off the post. That's a chance the other way. 2v1 odd man rush, but it's cast aside again, and they change possession a couple times in the next 5 seconds as this will go into the Game of Throws corner.
Good job there from Game of Throws, just being able to stop the offense for right now. Mom by me, Lagos, they're still pressing though, and they have to make sure to not make a mistake on defense. Obviously a great save there from Andy in front of the net, as you see the offense starting to creep from Mom by me, Lagos, but they gotta play this game into their own hands, because they're giving up possession here and there. In Game of Throws, they're just gonna continue to run out the clock.
Minute 56 to go in game one. Game of Throws looking to try to cinch this. Mom by me, Legos needs a clear. Lego has the ball in his possession. Gonna take it up on one flick, try to second one. That's gonna go off the lateral wall. Mom rotating back in, takes a shot. That's gonna be off the crossbar though. Very close, could not quite get it home. Minute 36 to go, still 3-0.
And you see Lego getting beats the ball. Mom has to cover and save the offense, so to speak. Big demo, that's gonna go in, and Lego's able to get one on the board.
Lego gets the demo before the clear can happen. That is a big, big play, and that's with a minute 29 seconds to go. They're still in this. There's a lot of time left in Rocket League.
I love how he does it all in one swift motion, gets the demo, and he still has the flick, and he does. And he's able to put that in to steer the ball towards the net all in one go. It's a great offensive effort from Lego. Come on, get one. That's going to be the two for Mom by Me, Legos. Back-to-back goals here.
They call this a fullback return. This is Lego going for the goal line and clearing out any potential defense, and that is Game of Throws, who has to dodge the incoming offensive player and take the ball away. It's not going to happen. 3-2.
Yeah, it's tough for Game of Throws. I mean, dropping two goals back-to-back is not going to do well in terms of like confidence on defense, but they still have to come back and take control of the game. 1:15 left on the clock. We know Mom by Me, Legos can score here.
Yep.
And equalizes. They've done it before.
They may do it here. Lego towards the goal line, but a nice takeaway and a nice defensive stand as they try to get to the last third. This will be a takeaway, 1v1 back the other side. It's off the lateral wall. Get it back to midfield. That's a shot towards the net, and it's Lego tying the game up at 3.
Big goal from Lego here to equalize. He receives that ball, just takes it, hits it off that sidewall, and a beautiful redirect right over Parker. Parker was not expecting the touch. He tried to get back in time, but unable to. And just like Game of Throws, score 3 unanswered. Mom by Me, Legos retaliate with 3. And we still got less than a minute on the clock left, Curtis.
Exactly 51 seconds that you just alluded to, and a lot can happen in those 51. Mom is going to try to land on top of this ball that's taken away by Parker. Parker gets it into the offensive territory. One of these teams has a hero on it. Who's it going to be? Is one both these teams looking for a spot in the grand finals? Lego misses the opportunity to make contact. Mom's in a tough spot. Andy trying to make something happen. He's got both members of Lego scrambling. That's a flick towards the net, and it's going to go wide. It's a nice save there by Parker to keep that one away. This is long into the Lego end. Good clear. That goes towards the Mom by Me, Legos net. Mom gets one off the nose with the Dominus. Chance off the back wall for Game of Throws. Into the middle. Good turn. Can they get the fourth unanswered? That's off the back. And it's a long ricochet as they will put this off the lateral wall. Still 2 seconds left. One. It's still in the air. Set towards the net. We have OT in game one.
Lego did a great job of killing that ball. Did not want to risk a possible goal from Game of Throws. He's in a tough spot, and that's the smart move to make as we enter OT. This is anyone's game. Wait, can Andy close it out? And he does with the flick. Curtis.
Oh, man. Unreal play by Andy. The hesitation and the slow play is what had Lego beaten from the onset. If he goes fast at Lego, Lego stops him. But the fact that he stopped and controlled it, had the flick, he had him all day.
What a win there from Game of Throws. They come in and they have such a great opening here in game number one. They scored 3 goals back to back, and then they have control of the game. But you see Mom by Me, Legos. We know that this is a strong team, and they keep at it, and they score, again, 3 unanswered to equalize. So we go into this OT, anybody's game, but that doesn't stop Game of Throws. They keep that energy going, and after a great kickoff play, they're able to take game number one.
Super competitive game one. Game of Throws continuing the momentum they had from a 3-game series they just finished against Mech OG, another very competitive series. Love to see that, because these guys are ready to play no matter what the situation. But Mom by Me, Legos, they've shown you and I on multiple occasions, they're not out of any situation. They can come back no matter how much they are down.
Yeah, and we saw that, right? We saw the field awareness from Mom, though, able to just get those flicks over he got the third goal, I would say, over Parker in the middle of the match. And it forced Parker to kind of stay back and be play on that more wider rotations. It's funny because that's how Game of Thrones was catching on by Milagos out. They were being overly aggressive on offense, so there were some pinches that didn't work in their favor. But now, like, we're starting to see how if one team starts to shake up, the other team's ready just to take advantage of that.
Well, we get ready for game number two, and don't look now, but the Game of Thrones guys are one win away from a spot in our grand finals. This will be top of the box in the Game of Thrones. And immediately, Lego off the intersection corner. It'll bounce down. It looks like Parker's going to take it towards the sidewall. Give it up to Andy. That's going to bounce off the corner wall as we play early on. 15 seconds into game number two. This is a chance from Lego directly on Cage, but a nice save by Parker as he gets there just in the nick of time.
That's what I want to see more of in terms of Mom by me Legos. Definitely more of an offensive effort from Legos, getting some good shots in. We've seen Mom be able to take Game of Thrones out of place and really punish them for their mistakes, but I want to see more of that offense from Lego as we get into game.
This will be Andy off the ceiling, going to try to follow this off the near side and taken away by Lego. Lego back the other way. He's got one to beat. Parker's on the back end of this. Oh, up and over the head of him. It's going to be a chance, but a defensive touch by Andy is going to quell any opportunity. Now Mom will take it away. Mom looking for a pass into the center. That's going to go right in the wheelhouse of Lego. Lego comes in, tries to put one towards the net, ends up putting it a little bit high, and the defensive touch by Andy is too good for Mom by Me Lego to take advantage.
You can see both teams starting to slow this down. They know the control of the game. Everyone's awareness meters are going off. It's like everyone has spider senses at this point. Not trying to make a mistake. We talk about one Parker. Whew, not able to get a touch, but luckily Andy comes back and is able to make the save. That's got to get them out there.
Yep, and the score is still scoreless as we play a minute 30 in, roughly. This will be back for Andy. Andy up the sidewall. He will wait, try to boost into it. He'll actually wait patiently and decide to come off the wall. That's off the back, coming in Parker. Parker takes a shot. It's going to be off the post. Mom in a dangerous spot. Oh, just across the goal mouth. But it stays out for the moment. Still scoreless as we play almost 2 minutes in.
Yeah, Parker tried to find an angle, but looks like Andy's going to see if he can have one. He got a bump on Mom, but it wasn't enough as the angle of the ball was still going in that net.
Oh, man. Mom was very close to making this a thing, but the touch off the spoiler is too good. Mom tried to interfere, couldn't make it happen.
Yeah, you see Mom, he's on his way back. He wants to get there to make the touch, but Andy knows this, and he's trying to angle his car just to be as annoying as possible, and that small interference was just enough for Game of Thrones to take the lead.
3:05 to go in a 1-0 contest. This is game two. Game of Thrones already has the necessary amount of goals. They need to kill the next 3 minutes to secure a spot in the grand finals. Lego with the clear. It's right at Andy. Parker turning back in, but he realizes he's beat. Mom has him beat to it. This will go towards the corner. Pop into front. There's the takeaway by Andy. Andy's going to try to get there. Good touch by Mom. Gets it over the head of him. Parker with the intercept. Parker, angle play. Shot on net. It's off the post. Still there. Andy off the post as well. It's up the ramp. Mom looking for a clear and finds it off the sidewall. And back the other way come the Legos guys.
Yeah, and right now, this is a bad spot if you are Game of Thrones. It's a good touch from Andy, but he's still got more work to do to clear the ball. They're giving him a lot of room, but there's the demo. It's a 2v1 situation, but they're still playing it slow as they want to try to see if they can bait out the defense. They get both members, but Andy, luckily, is going to be able to make that good touch.
Contact he absolutely had to have there. Still about 2:08 to go, possibly in the tournament life of Mom Buy Me Legos. Chance for that is Parker. Parker coming down with it. He's going to try to push this to the center. Mom takes control. That's in front. That's off the back. Nobody there to return to center. That's a runner back the other way. That is Lego on net. Empty net scores. Tie game with 1:50 to go.
Mom by Me Legos are not done just yet, Curtis. A misplay on offense, and Mom sees Lego downfield. A great pass turns into a good shot as there's, like you said, 1:50 left, and we're tied here. They cannot drop this game.
110 seconds on the clock. Good kick goes neutral towards the sidewall. In comes Mom. Mom has the angle. That's off the back. Tries for the double and gets it off the nose, but well wide of its intended target. Now coming in, Parker. Parker on the dribble try. That's going to go towards the sidewall. Coming in, Andy. Andy will wait patiently, then take it away. That's a real nice play. Off the back he goes, but it looks like Lego is going to stop that from going where he wants. Still high, still off the back. And it gets sent back, returned to sender as the Mom by Me Legos guys can get regrouped in their own end.
And you can see that Game of Thrones is in a tough spot. It's a good touch from Andy, but That was all in control of Mambai Milagos. That's going to be a big demo as a breakaway seems to happen downfield.
This will be back the other way for Lego. Lego can't control it in that offensive corner. Now comes Parker. Parker loses that, and he's going to get up. He's going to try to get there first. He will, and he'll send that deep into Lego territory. You know, I was just thinking about it. If somebody Goomba stomps one of the Mambai Milagos guys, is that technically kind of stepping on Legos?
If it's on Lego.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense. Okay. This is going to be off the sidewall. Chance for Parker. Parker loses that to Mom. Still in the neutral zone. Mom lands on top of it, gets a second piece of contact. Off the nose, tries the carry. Parker waiting patiently on his own goal line, waiting to see what's going to happen. Now he can go up the sidewall here. He's free to do so. They're going to try to run the other goalie. Shot towards the net, and a big save by Lego as he gets there just in the nick of time. 15 seconds to go. One of these teams has a goal in them. We have to find one before the end of this second game. If Game of Thrones scores, technically they move ahead.
Oh my
goodness. If
Lego
scored, we go to game three. 4 seconds to go. Lego can't get there. And we are looking possibly at OT. Mom towards the net. That's a chance. Oh, Andy comes across with a nice save.
It's still up.
It's still in the air. That's off the back. Oh, very close. How about it falls down on Andy? Andy back the other way. We don't want this to end. It's
oh my goodness!
What? Andy puts it in, and Game of Thrones is moving to the grand finals.
They kept it up and brought it all the way back downfield, Curtis, and Andy's going to be the one to beat Mom into the ball
man.
And send it home.
That's incredible by Andy and Parker, and Mom by Me Legos are absolutely heartbroken because they could have had OT there, could not get the kill, and Game of Thrones moves it all the way back to the other end to put it in. That's incredible.
I can't believe what we just saw. I cannot believe what we just saw.
We were one angled shot away from a This Is Rocket League.
please. Oh my goodness. Incredible performance from Game of Thrones. It looked like there were so many things going on. Could have been a possible OT. All the ball had to do was touch the ground.
Yeah.
Could have been a game three scenario. Mom had an opportunity to set that up to score, but that's not what happened. Game of Thrones, they played the ball right, sent it downfield, and were able to perform one of the most clutch 0 second goals I've seen. I'll
unreal. And we take it. We I hope the mics caught everybody over at the big screen watching that, because the entire place that's watching Rocket League just erupted for that last second goal. That was intense.
I got on my chair.
Yeah, we both stood up. That's fine. With that said, we are going to get one of the members of Game of Thrones over here to have a conversation with Dazrin. I'm going to step out. We will take a quick break while we get that organized. We'll be back here at MidwestLAN 20.